I'm gonna start the recording. Ok, so bienvenue tout le monde à la classe de français. Et aujourd'hui, c'est dimanche 10 janvier. Et bien sûr, bonjour tout le monde. I hope you had a very good winter break, that you were able to rest. Remember also that here in the class, right now you cannot write in the chat, you cannot ask me anything, but after, once we are done, you can make questions if you want, okay? So remember, we're using French Smart 4, because I know you're also here for French Smart 5 sometimes. We are doing this one, it's 4 right now, and we are at Unit 5, Unité 5. Okay, so today we have the months of the year. Remember, the last class was the days of the week. This one is the months of the year. Aujourd'hui, c'est, today is, and here I have an example, aujourd'hui, c'est le 14 janvier. Today is February 14th, okay? If you can see, it's very different from the English one, so pay attention. So, okay, so today we're going to have, first of all, vocabulaire, the vocabulary, all the months, this activité. And then we also have expressions to say what day is today. Okay, so let's start avec le vocabulaire. And here we have the sort of activity you have to do. It's copy les mots, copy the words. First one was janvier. Remember, we don't pronounce the R here on janvier. Février, we also don't pronounce the R. Avril, mars. Here we pronounce the S, May, and there we have Juin, Juillet, Août. We write all these letters, but we only say Août. Also remember that you can, even if I cannot hear you, you can repeat after me the French words. Septembre, Octobre, Novembre, Décembre. Remember that it's not September, November, December, it's bre. Octobre, septembre, novembre, décembre. Okay, pay attention to that. And then we have the month, that is les mois. It's so easy. So I will go over this again. Remember that you just needed to copy these ones. Janvier, février, avril, mars, mai, juin, juillet, août, septembre, octobre, novembre, décembre, and here we have les mois. Also remember that you have a little draw in each of them, a picture, a small picture, so you can remember which one is each month, because some of them are very different from the ones we have in English. Okay, so here let's go with the activities, avec les activités. And here you had, écrivez les mots de votre mois favori et celui de votre anniversaire. You need to write the name of your favorite month and the month of your birthday in French. And this is dans la page 29, but I cannot correct this one because this is up to you, whatever is your favorite month or whenever is your the month of your birthday, okay? So you need also to pay attention because in English, the names of the months begin with a capital letter. But in French, they begin with a lowercase letter, unless they are at the beginning of the sentence. Remember that every time we start the sentence, I think in every single language, it starts with a capital letter. Oh no, not writing. Okay, so here, there we go. I will have to delete that, so yes. Okay, so here, remember, please, this is very important that we in English do it with a capital letter, but in French we don't do it with a capital letter, okay? So here we have remplissez les tirets pour compléter les noms du mois. Fill in the blanks to complete the name of the month. So in this case, you will need just to fill with the letters that are missing. I'm going to write it down here. Février, remember with the accent here, février. Juin, sorry, octobre, December, also with an accent, December. Please pay attention if you did write it right. Then we have November. This is M and this is R. Then we have Juillet, is U and an E. Then we have Avril. April here. Then we have Mars. The missing letter is A. Then we have Oot. September. Like this. Then we have May. Then we have Janvier. So if you already have done these activities prior to the class, check if you have them right. Don't miss any letters because those are important. It's going to be very, very important. So we have February, Juin, October, December, November, Avril, Juillet, Mars, Août, September, May, and then we have Janvier. Please check that the letters are correct on the ones, the activities that you made, and if you haven't made them, or you can make them now and correct them. Okay? Okay. So let's keep going with the next activity. And here we have écrivez les mois correspondants sous chaque image. Write the corresponding month under each picture. And here we need to think a lot about the seasons, right? Because you have all different pictures with all different meanings too. Here we have summer, here we have Halloween, here we have autumn, right? Okay, so the first one, it's Avril. The second one, it's Décembre. The third one, Octobre. The next one, Septembre. The other one, it's Juillet. And this one, it's May. And this is corresponding to, for example, Décembre. Remember, it's winter in December and you can go ski, right? Then we have Juillet, that is l'été, if you remember the seasons, it's summer. Octobre, we have Halloween, the 31st. So yes. And then we have April, and usually in April, it rains a lot here. So yes, okay. Remember that you also had all these months here, and you will need to fill the blanks with the ones that you have here. Okay, so pay attention, please. If you have any questions, write them down and you can ask me afterwards, okay? Okay, oh, I also see eBay. Okay. So, are we ready? Can I continue with the next one? Yes, okay. Très bien. On va continuer. Trouvez les mots cachés dans la grille et écrivez-les dans le bon ordre. Find the names of the months in the word search and write them in the correct order. So remember, these are the months of the year. Janvier, février, mars, avril, mai, juin, juillet, août, septembre, octobre, novembre, et décembre. For the ones that haven't done it yet, I will give you a few minutes, so maybe you can complete it down now. If you haven't done that yet, it's very, very easy. Remember also that each letter you have many cues. Oh, I see Li Wen, you already did it perfectly. I see it. That's very, very good. Okay, très bien. I'll give you just a few minutes. I see Yi also did it. Parfait, très bien. That's very, very good. Okay. Oh, I see Vincent also did it. I think this exercise was also very, very easy, but just in case, now I will show you the answers, but pay attention because if you miss one letter, it's very important. Usually for November, December, those ones, you always need to include the E that is in the end, okay? So it's very, very important. So here we have Janvier is the first one. It's here, it's all the way backwards. So remember to include every letter. Check well, please. Then we have février. Remember that you also need to include every single letter. Don't miss the R. Then we have mars. Remember to include every single letter. Then we have avril. That one was easy. It was just right. Probably it's the first one you found just in the middle of the screen there, in the page when you had it. Then we also have May. The good thing about avril is very, very similar to April. It changes one letter only. Then we have May, that means May, remember? Then we have Juin, it's there. Juillet, pay attention because now we're gonna be overlapping some of them. Then we have Août, this one is reading backwards. Maybe you haven't found this one. Please pay attention that you have it like this. Then you also have September. It's this one. Let's go with Octobre. It's here. It's very, very easy to see. Then we have Novembre, that is all the way from the bottom to the top. And then we have Décembre, that is very, very easy to find there too. Okay, so I will leave it there for a few seconds so you can compare and complete if it's right or not. You can see it there. Okay, okay, okay. Vincent has a very, very thinking face like this. Do I have it right? Yes. Okay, that's really, really good. Okay, let's continue with the next one. And here we're going right into the expressions. And l'expression that we have here, it's saying the date, which is very, very important in the order we say. Because en anglais, in English, today is day, month, and date, and then we have the year, right? For example, today is Tuesday, April 9th, 2013. But in French, en français, aujourd'hui, aujourd'hui means today. Aujourd'hui, c'est le. It's day, date, and month. Here, we're gonna change this, okay? Aujourd'hui, c'est le, 2013. For example, aujourd'hui, c'est le mardi 9 avril 2013. D'accord? Okay. So, right after, you already have an exercise. I'm going to leave you a few seconds in case you want to complete it. Here we have août, samedi 17. Juin, lundi 10. Juillet, vendredi 5. It's very, very small, but you can see it, at least in your notebook, it's going to be even more clear. So here we have, aujourd'hui, c'est le samedi 17 août 2013. So we're going to include the day, the number, and the month. Okay. Oh, Yami, I see you raising your hand. Give me 1 second. Then we have, aujourd'hui, c'est le lundi 10 juin 2013. Aujourd'hui, c'est le vendredi 5 juillet 2013. And if you have noticed, every time we start the class, I always write down the date there. Dimanche 10, like this one. Dimanche 10 janvier 2021. Okay. You always see it, and you always see dimanche because we always have it in Sunday, right? So you always have the same one, the same day. But remember, it's always like this, the day, the number, and the month. It's always gonna be like that. And sometimes you don't have to include the year. You need to, you can do it without including the year, okay? As long as you use the day, the number, and the month, okay? And also remember that the month has lowercase. You don't use it capital letter here. No, it's always lowercase the way it starts. Okay. 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 So now, yes, you can use the chat. I'm going to enable now. And now you can also unmute yourself if you have any questions, because we are done with this. So if you want to ask something, you can do it. Oh, hi, Evelyn. Hello, hello. Do you have any questions, anybody? Maybe about this or anything? Nope. Is it clear? I think this is very easy, and it's just about practicing a lot. So maybe if you want to practice this, take the calendar and write down many dates, just random dates that you want, and always put the day of the week, the number, and the month. Can you leave them? Yes. We are done. Oops, cups, it's okay. So next class is going to start in 20 minutes exactly. If you have any questions that you want to ask, you can stay and ask anything you want. If not, you can leave. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Au revoir. Remember that we have French five, French Smart by French Smart 5, 11:20. Bye bye, Yvonne. Au revoir, Maxwell. Bye bye, Lee. Remember also that you can stay if you want, if you have any questions. Okay, bye bye.
Do we have to come back?
For French 5, yes. If you want to just not leave and to just mute yourself, you can do that too. But for French 5, yes. French Smart 5, yes.
So you wait for like 20 minutes and then come back?
Yes, you can do that.
Okay.
Yes. Okay.